Ladies and gentlemen and assembled phonograph owners, especially those of you with needles, it has come to my attention that a great many of the mothers in this country are mothers of children. Now, this is good and bad, for sometimes just when you are about to go out to your weekly meeting of the Saturday Night Backgammon and Load Your Own Dice Society, the little tots will come up to you and ask you to tell them just one more fairy tale before you leave. Well, now, frequently you just don't have the time for the full story, so today I shall give a brief lesson on how to tell a complete fairy tale in half the normal time. Are we ready? Then here, just as fast as I can tell it, is the story of Little Red Riding Hood. Well, once upon a time, a little girl lived with her mother in a big, great big house on the other side of the woods. The name of the little girl was Little Red Riding Hood. One day, her mother said to her, Red, she said, Red, your grandmother's lying in a little house on the other side of the woods with a broken arm. Last night, she was celebrating her 93rd birthday, and she slipped on a beer bottle and broke her arm. Now, I fixed up a very nice basket of goodies for you to take to your grandma. Little Riding Hood said, what's in the basket, Maha? What's in the basket, And her mother said, oh, not much in the basket. Just an apple, an orange, a lemon, a lemon, a pickle, a pie, and a pound of steak, a bottle of butter, and a box of beans, a carrot, a cake, and a can of corn, a herring, a hog, a hat full of hash, and 14 doses of bicarbonate of soda. Now, Red, she said, now, Red, you take this basket to your grandma's house on the other side of the wood, but don't go through the woods, take the bus. Well, you know how a kid is about a little thing like that. They don't pay attention to what the mother says. Bush, mush, you takes the bus. So off she goes walking through the woods. Well, it's a very pretty day. The sun is shining. The world is bright. When all of a sudden, she hears a terrible cry. And what do you think hops out of the woods? What do you think hops out of the woods? A wolf, a great big nasty wolf. And the wolf says, what do you got in the basket, babe? What do you got in the basket? And she says, what do you care what I got in the basket? I got an apple, an orange, a lemon, a lemon, a pickle, a pie, and a pound of steak, a bottle of butter, a box of beans, a carrot, a cake, and a can of corn, a herring, a hog, a hat full of hash, none of your big fat business. Well, so what does the wolf do? What does he do? He goes, he takes a shortcut through the woods to grandma's house. And before you can say boo, he breaks into the house and he eats grandma all of it. Excuse me. And then what does he do? Then what does he do to this big bear wolf? Puts all of grandma's clothes on. And believe it or not, he looks just like grandma, looks exactly like grandma. They both needed a shave. And he no sooner gets into the bed than what does he hear coming? Who does he hear coming? The little Red Riding Hood. She walks up to her grandma's house. She knocks on the door. Knock, 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 knock. The wolf says, come in. She goes in. She says, hiya, grandma, how's the kid? The wolf says, just fine. What do you got in the basket? Eat, gad, says Red. I got an apple, an orange, a lemon, lime, a pickle, a pie, a pound of steak, a bottle of butter, a box of beans, a carrot, a cake, a can of corn, a herring, a hog, a hat full of hash, and I hope you choke on the stuff. And just then she begins to notice something funny. She says to the wolf, she says, Jesus, scrapers, what big tables, grandma. And the wolf says, duh, better to see you with, my dear. And Red says, and get a load of those ears. Have you been frightened by a helicopter? And the wolf says, duh, better to hear you with, my dear. Yeah, but get a load of them teeth, says Red. And with that, the wolf hops out of bed and yells, the better to eat you with, my dear. Ah! Well, then the action really starts. Round around the room, the wolf is chasing Red, and Red is yelling, save me, save me. Why don't somebody come in and save me? And outside the cottage is a great big lumberjack who is sawing down trees. And when he hears Red screaming, he picks up his axe, runs into the house, and clonk, he bops the wolf right on top of the noggin, a hole in one. My hero, yells Red, my hero, will you marry me? And the woodsman says, I'd love to marry you. But before I marry you, you got to answer me one question. What do you got in the basket, babe? She says, I've got an apple, an orange, a lemon, a lime, a pickle, a pie, a pound of steak, a bottle of butter, a box of beans, a carrot, a cake, a can of corn, a herring, a hog, and nuts, let it go. So she goes back home, settles down, becomes an old maid, lives happily ever after. And that is the story of Little Red Riding Hood.